This is Unspeakable, and this is Unspeakable's house. Ooh, look at that red concrete. This looking like a snack over here. We have to do a little bit of demolition. Look at all the lootations. And today we are using our shrink ray to not only sneak past Unspeakable, but to build the world's tiniest house underneath Unspeakable's house. Looks like he just went upstairs. Now we gotta find a place very quickly where we wanna start digging underneath his house. We have to find the most seclusive location possible. I'm thinking like right here is very sneaky. There's no way he would notice us building the house right here, or we're gonna undo this. What if, wait, this might be perfect. We could technically, oh my gosh, guys, we're gonna do it in the water. Check this out, guys. We're going to mine into this corner block just like this. Okay, we have to be very, very careful. But if we could pull this off, check it out. From over here, you can't even tell. You cannot even tell that there's any blocks missing unless you were to come directly in here. But why would he do that? Guys, check it out. This is working perfectly. We are now beginning our underground tunnel to the tiniest house underneath Unspeakable's house. If you guys want to, I am going to link every single mod that I am using. If you guys want to use this against your friends, you are more than welcome to, because it is so much fun. You can adjust the hammer size so you can break more or less blocks. I've got it set to a 6 right now, so we could perfectly go all the way down and notice how the water doesn't follow us because of how tiny the hole is that we made. This water literally cannot follow us down here. So now we just got to keep going deeper and deeper. We don't want to go too deep because I still want to see Unspeakable and monitor his movements as he's above us. Please leave a like on this video if you want to see more trolling videos on Unspeakable. This is where we get to have the most fun, because we are going to try to build the first ever underground tunnel system inside of Unspeakable's house. Let me give you guys a tour. When you come down the hallway, look to your left. This is where we're going to be building our very tiny bedroom part of the house. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use our little chisel. Using the little chisel, select right here and go to slice, and we're going to change this to red wool. As you guys know, my favorite color is red. Most of our PrestonStyles.com merchandise is red because I love red. If you guys love red, let me see some fire emojis down below in the comments. Using the slice feature, we can then build a ramp into the house. Check this out. Boom! Now, I think this ramp's a little bit too big. I don't want the ramp to be, like, huge. I want it to be big, but it shouldn't be that big. I think this is the perfect size. Now, we can just literally walk up the ramp, walk down the ramp, no problem. Then, I think that the next thing that's gotta go, obviously, all of these walls. We gotta do something about the walls. I do not like having dirt and gravel walls. It is just pitiful, ladies and gentlemen. Nobody likes that in their house. I'm more of a modern guy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to use white wool with the box feature. And what we could do is we could select two different points inside of here, changing the walls all to white, including the ceiling. Unless we wanted to do a different color ceiling, we could try to do something really funny. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do. We're gonna do orange flooring. Like, don't judge me, guys. I just love the color orange. I think it looks so cool. Like, how much better does this room already look? Now, I'm gonna go with a neutral color. So I think I'm gonna select the black wool because I think black wool looks awesome. We can put that on the ceiling. Oh, this looks so cool. Warning, this is probably a very highly flammable bedroom. So please, if you guys find my tiny house, do not bring any, don't bring anything like a candle, okay? Or a torch, because that is going to set my house on fire. Now, we're gonna redo our little slice staircase we made earlier because I want it to match. So now everything looks so cool and you can still walk up. You can walk down very easily. Oh, hold on, hold on. I gotta add a little bit of black wool over here. So what do we want inside of our bedrooms, ladies and gentlemen? I know Unspeakable's above us and it has me very nervous, but we can't let this stop. I'm thinking about building a massive bed, like a huge bed. I am a big fan of sleep, ladies and gentlemen. You gotta get your sleep. Sleep is what keeps us healthy and keeps us alive, so never ever be judged for sleeping, okay? As you viewers probably know, I am a man of modern taste. I like the very modern home designs. So we're gonna do, we got four little legs for our bed, but I still like a splash of color. So we're gonna now do red concrete on the top. Ooh, look at that red concrete. This looking like a snack over here. Then we are going to make a giant pillow. We're gonna raise that. Oh, dude, how comfy. Guys, in the comments right now, I wanna see you all rate my bed. because I think it looks so comfortable. Dare I say it, ladies and gentlemen, this might be the most comfortable looking bed I have ever made in my entire Minecraft video career. Guys, check out these tiny little nightstands I made right next to my bed. You gotta admit, they look really good. And just like that, the bedroom is complete. We must move on to the kitchen area. I know, big shocker, guys. Once again, Preston being the modern man he is, we are going to be using chiseled quartz blocks to use and build inside of our kitchen. I think that quartz is probably one of my favorite blocks to build within Minecraft. It just looks so clean. They need to put me on Extreme Home Makeover on, what is that? What's it called? Is it like HGTV? I'm sure your sister or your mom probably watches it. My mom and sister watch it all the time. Honestly though, this is kind of so bright. It hurts my eyes a little bit. Not a lot, just a little bit. Now we got our block of iron because we got to build like a massive refrigeration system. I mean, we are trying to survive underneath Unspeakable's house without getting caught. And we can't do it unless we have ourselves a lot of food. It's so weird. Like, you guys don't understand how hard it is to build with this mod until you use it for yourself. It's actually very difficult. What is this? Colored wooden plank. Hold on, guys. I have never seen this in my entire life, and I love it. The color is very similar to the scheme that I want to build our kitchen out of. First thing is first, we gotta build some cabinets. Please tell me that you guys like these cabinets. I spent way too much time working on them and making sure they were perfect. Now, what do you need inside of a kitchen, ladies and gentlemen? You need burners, because we got to be able to cook our food skadoodles. We might add a little bit of this area here so we can add a couple of stovetop burners. I love how this looks. It looks so cool. Just because we can, we're gonna go the extra mile. We're going to get a little bit of the red, ooh, you know what, block of redstone. And in the middle, we're gonna add it so it looks like a full burner. It kind of looks like a music CD disc, but I promise you guys, these are burners. And of course, we need to have control knobs for them. And then we're going to need ourselves a sink. Now, the unfortunate thing about the sink is I'm unable to put water inside of it because water doesn't work, okay? You can't fit, I don't think you can spawn. Can you make? I'm going to see if we can put water. Oh, wait, we can? Wait a second, guys. Oh my gosh, this just changed everything. I did not know that we could make tiny water. And with this, we can have a tiny sink. Look at that. Look at that tiny water faucet. That looks so cool. Why am I geeking out over this? I don't know. Put some knobs over here for the sink. Okay, so wait, if we could do that, we could definitely make a trash can. Like, we gotta make like a little disposal area inside of here. If this works, I am going to freak out, guys. Now, the bad thing is this is made of wood, so I don't know if this is going to catch on fire. And if it does catch on fire, we are going to lose everything inside of our kitchen. So hopefully it does not happen. But inside of here, I'm thinking about putting a little disposal area. I don't know. Why do I love this so much? I feel like I shouldn't love this. Wait, does it actually set me on fire? Oh, it does. Okay, ow, ow. Bad idea, guys. While I'm sitting here burning on fire, do me a favor, guys. It's subscribe time. Take the device you're watching this video on. Turn it like this. Make that red subscribe button gray and enable those notifications. Survive with two hearts. Not bad, Preston, not bad. Oh, I forgot. Okay, the most important part, the freezer / refrigerator. How did we almost forget about this? This is kind of a big deal. I'm gonna like etch out a small like handle. This is where a handle would go, or maybe, wait, does this look better? Actually, I think that looks better. It looks like a giant handle to the refrigerator. Ooh, looks so clean. Okay, so we've got our freezer. We could cook our food over here. We've got our disposal, aka our little lava area over here. Now we gotta get a big kitchen table. Now, this room is very monochromatic, which means it's very bland right now. Like, there's no pops of color, so I am going to build, wait, dare I say it? Technically, we could build a lava table. No, okay, I'm not gonna build, if I built a lava table, that might be a little bit dangerous. We're not gonna do that, although I really want to. All right, so we're going for that modern table design. In order to have the perfect modern table, we are going to need to be very delicate about this process. I think this is gonna be enough to hold our table. It should. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm only putting these down here. These are gonna be like our selection points. Orange glass table, coming right in. Ooh. I am a huge fan of this table. Now, wait, okay, now this is the delicate part. We've got to add plates. Now, the question is, how do we build chairs? Like, I'm a little bit worried about building chairs for this thing. That's way too big of a chair. Ooh, you know what we should do? Okay, before we build chairs for our table, we do need a pantry. I just realized we have no place to store our food. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select the hollow option with this chisel. Put the pantry down right over here. So when you mine it out, it's actually gonna be hollow on the inside. It's kind of like magic. Oh, dude. Okay, inside the pantry, we should probably add some shelves. Not too many shelves, just a little bit of shelves. You know what I got? Just a little bit of shelves. If we put too many in here, we won't be able to fit inside, and that would be a no-no. We do want to be able to fit inside of our pantry. And actually, we should make the shelves of a different color so they stand out a little bit more. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that looks so much better. Guys, I know I don't want to be that guy, but this might be the best tiny house build on YouTube. I don't think I've ever seen a better YouTube tiny house build. There probably is one, so don't link it to me. But it's, you gotta admit, this is looking awesome. You know what? The chairs are gonna take too long, so the last thing that is missing from our tiny house underneath Unspeakable's house is a secret diamond room where we could store all of our valuables, and Unspeakable will never find them even if he manages to find our tiny house. This is gonna be really hard to pull off, so what I'm gonna do is inside of the pantry, I'm going to put the smallest hole, and I'm gonna put it right here. And what this hole is going to lead to is a chest that has all of our insane valuables inside of it. So I'm going to have to do a little bit of demolition. I don't want to do this, but if we don't do this, I will not be able to put the chest inside of here. So we have to do a little bit of demolition. Then we gotta switch over to game mode. What we have to do is we have to break regular, okay, we did not break this. That is what matters, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so we gotta go deeper with our hammer. Yeah, there we go. Okay, our hammer has gone as deep as I think we could go. That's it, guys. This is the secret hole. So what we could do, let's go into our inventory. We're gonna get two chests, and we're gonna can we open it? Oh, we might not be able. Okay, hold on. We might need to clear out. We gotta clear out above us. We do need to be able to open up this chest. If we can't open the chest, that is going to pose a little bit of a problem. Okay, yes! We can open the chest, guys! All right, so now what we gotta do, this is so epic, dude! Seal this area off completely so nobody knows it even exists. Nobody is going to notice this tiny hole. Because look, you have to go into it, right-click, and then you can get access to your chest. So now we gotta get all of our diamonds that we've been saving up. There's also another trick to this chest. So if you have something in your hands and you try to right-click it, like, look, I'm trying to right-click, I'm trying to open the chest, it doesn't open unless your hand is free. But if you manage to make it inside, look at all the lootations! This is insane! And I think what we could do to make this even more secret, maybe we should cover this up. I don't want Nathan to find this. I don't want you guys commenting on Nathan. Do not tell Nathan about this secret, guys. Okay, I will be very upset if you tell Nathan about the secret. If you tell Nathan about this secret, we can't be best friends anymore, guys. I just made the hole even more sneaky. The hole is now even more sneaky. This is the maximum sneaky level, guys. This is the time I remind you guys, if you make it to a brand new video within the first hour, I will read your comments and feature them down below, so make sure you guys get here in the first hour of a brand new video. Remember, do not tell Unspeakable what you saw here. Have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time. Yeah.